Hey, let's take a minute and talk about the Rooster Teeth store. Have you guys checked it out lately?
It's our 10-year anniversary, if you can believe it, and we've got some amazing shirts for the occasion, like how we're bringing back fights.
I can't believe it, Wiz, and please don't remind me about it again, because time is an illusion.
Well, despite Boomstick's existential dread, you can get t-shirts, hoodies, hats, and tons more from your favorite Rooster Teeth shows and brands right now.
And keep an eye out this month for our biggest and best Pride collection ever, where part of the proceeds go to Out Youth.
Scan the QR code below or head over to store.roosterteeth.com to start shopping right away.
Every 10 years in the mountains of Tibet, the mystical lost city of Kunlun will appear, forever guarded by a legendary warrior, the Iron Fist.
Naturally, one of the Iron Fist's former apprentices, Wendell Rand, thought, I should really bring my wife and kid to visit the Kung Fu Super City. Best family vacation ever!
But not so naturally, Wendell's business partner tagged along, Harold Meacham, who, surprise, had less than noble intentions.
So Wendell was sent off a cliff, and his son Danny won the tragic backstory lottery when his mom died protecting him from wolves. Never trust a herald, folks.
Danny survived and was adopted by the people of Kunlun. Within the city's walls, he spent his formative years tirelessly training in pursuit of revenge.
He's mastered judo, muay thai, aikido, pressure points, pretty much every cool fighting style around. He also gained a weird habit of shouting, Heart of the Dragon, whenever he's surprised. Oh, you know that guy's got at least like 6 silk dragon shirts in his closet.
That would be interesting foreshadowing. For when Danny turned 19, he had the chance to become the next Iron Fist. But he had to overcome one final challenge, the immortal dragon, Shu Lao.
And like a badass, Danny walked up to Shu Lao's front door, then, get this, bear-hugged the dragon until it fell unconscious, netting Danny a sweet chest tattoo and the chance to plunge his hands deep into the dragon's
boomstick.
What? I was gonna say the creepy cauldron holding its heart. What are you thinking?
This act infused Shu Lao's chi with Danny's, making him the newest, the immortal Iron Fist.
With his newfound power, Iron Fist did what any vengeful orphan would, and left Kunlun to track down the bastard who killed his parents.
However, when he found Harold, all the Iron Fist saw was a broken man. So he spared him, casting aside his past anguish to become a hero.
Oh great, another lesson about how revenge is bad and all that crap. Wiz, when I find those chickens that did in my grandpappy, make sure I finish the job.
I'll put it on my calendar. Thanks to his friend, Luke Cage, Iron Fist was able to reconnect with the real world and co-found a team, the Heroes for Hire.
And when he wasn't superheroing, Iron Fist was actually a pretty good dude who used his money to start a soup kitchen. Because he's yet another superhero who is secretly a billionaire by inheritance.
Shh, quiet, Boomstick. Half our unfulfilled loans come from billionaires.
I will not be silenced until someone shows up on my door and tells me that some guy I didn't know died and I get money.
You will be if they decide to find us. I mean, that's all for now, folks. Come back later when we go over Iron Fist's new Poe, the Kung Fu Panda, Foe. Wait, whatever.
Hey, you made it rhyme. Good for you. Maybe that could be your thing and you can fuck off with the puns.